I was 7 years old, and Bank Holiday Tuesday, August the 4th. At breakfast, my father said, "I think I'll go into the city this morning. I want to get some leather." He was used to repair the children's shoes and boots, mainly boots in the winter time, and he decided to go and buy this leather. He thought it would be a good opportunity for him to do the repairs while he was on holiday. So after breakfast, he went. I suppose really it was round about 10 o'clock when he set off. I went out into the roadway to play with my friends. When I'd been playing hopscotch for some time, I happened to look down the road and I saw my father coming up the road. And he was talking to everybody, and there were crowds of people gathering round him, and I couldn't understand it, and I went down to meet him. Well, my father had gone into the city, and when he got into New Street, he found there were crowds of people there, especially round by the Birmingham Mail Office, which at that time was in New Street. And he saw a placard outside. It was just after 11 o'clock when he was there, and this placard outside said, "War declared." And he was very upset and thought, "Oh dear, I must get back home." And he went into the mail office and he bought a paper and he stood and read it, and then he decided that he wouldn't walk home. He'd walked into town and he decided he wouldn't walk back. He'd come back on the electric tram so as to get home quicker. As soon as he got off the tram to come home, and he was showing everybody the paper, nobody knew anything about it, you see. He was showing everybody his paper, and as he came up the road and I saw him, and I was surprised to see him because he told my mother he would be home at dinner time, which was usually 1 o'clock, and this was about 12. And I went down, you see, to see what I could see. Something was happening, and I went down, and I was just in time. He was just saying to Mrs. West, "Yes, I'm afraid it's true. The war has started." "Oh dear," she said. "Oh dear," he said. "Our soldiers are already in France," and she said, "Oh," and she was so upset. She ran across the road to talk to her friend Mrs. Brown. And they called other neighbours, and they were all standing in groups, and my father gradually made his way up the road. People were coming to the gateways, and of course in those days with no noise in the road, no radios, no noise in the air at all, you could hear what was going on in the roadway, and if there was a lot of people calling to one another or anything like, you could hear it inside your homes, you see. Well, he gradually made his way up to the gate, and my mother was standing there with her neighbour. And he said, she said, "Oh, what is it, Will?" And he said, "We're at war with Germany." "Oh," she said, "you won't have to go, will you?" And he said, "Well, we shall see, we shall see," he said. And just upon it, up the top of the road, you could hear the mail boy shouting, "Special, special, special." And in those days, of course, with no radio or any means, I mean, there were very few telephones about anyway as well. And if there was anything happened, like a railway crash or trouble in the mines or an earthquake somewhere, then the mail would put out a special paper, and it would be printed and then rushed out to the suburbs so the people could hear the news. And this mail boy was coming down the road with these big heavy bags of mails on his back, shouting "special," and all the people were coming out of the houses, because as it was bank holiday, crowds of people were there, and they all came out and collected the mail to find out about the war starting.
When your father was coming down the road with his newspaper with the news of the outbreak of World War One, how much of a surprise was it?
Well, the people, of course, had in their newspapers about the shooting of the ex-Duke Ferdinand and in Sarajevo, and it had been in the newspapers, but they didn't imagine really that it would cause war, although the papers had been a little bit worried about it and people had talked about it. But on the day that the war actually broke out, people didn't know or imagine that war was going to break out on that day. They thought it might all blow over and everything be pleasant. So it really was a big surprise to know that war had actually broken out. My father and mother went into the house and they talked about whether they should get the boys back from camp, but they decided that if it was necessary, the scoutmaster would bring them home. So they remained at the camp.
It's a long way to Tipperary, but my heart's right there.